Hi everyone, I'm here to show you how to make the ribbon handle box. I have these the set of three boxes. They are in different heights. This is the medium sized one, and these are the pieces that you will be getting in your file. This is going to be the bottom with the bases, and this is going to be the lid with the two tops. Now the difference is, right now you can tell the difference because of the colors, but when you get your files you'll notice that the two tops are slightly larger than the two bases. I think you can see that right there. And another difference is that the bases have one solid circle and one with a little slit in it, and the tops have both have slits in them. So those are the big differences. So for the first step, I'm going to put together the base. It's really simple. All you need to do is add some glue to the tab on the side here, and you'll see a perforated edge there, or a line. So you just line up the opposite end with the perforations that you have there. Put the tab on the inside, and that's it. You let that dry a little bit, and I like turning these. Sometimes I do it before I fold over, sometimes I do it before, so whatever is your preference. It's fine. So now that this is completely dry and I've folded over my tabs, I'm going to put the base on the very bottom of the box. And all I do is add little dots of glue on each one of these tabs as close to the edge as I can get so that the lid really gets glued down really well and on the edge. Sometimes I add glue to the circle itself, sometimes I don't, it just depends. So we'll just push that a little bit and wait for the glue to dry. Okay, now that it's a little more dry, I turn it around and make sure that each of the tabs are flat on the bottom of the box. For the taller box, you'll probably need a little tool or something that you will be able to tap them down, maybe the eraser or top of a pencil or something like that. Now for the second part of the base, the inside part, you will have to use the slit version and 12 inches for the middle sized one of ribbon. And this ribbon is about, let me see, almost half an inch. It's slightly smaller than half an inch. And what you're going to do is thread it through the center of your circle and leave about half an inch of it on one end of the circle, just like this. We're going to add a little bit of glue here and a little bit of glue here, and that will hold, but I like to secure it with a piece of tape, just like so. It doesn't have to look pretty because you're not going to see this. And this is what it should look like on the other end. And now we'll add glue to this. Pretty generously, because this is going to be inside bottom of the box and you don't want the handle to fall off your box, so that when people carry it, it doesn't fall apart. And you tuck it in. And there you go. It's securely attached to the bottom. So that's the bottom of your box. Now we're going to take care of the cover. And basically it's the same sort of steps. You're going to add some glue to this tab. And like I said, sometimes I do this before, sometimes I do it after. Folding over the tabs, I'll do it before in this case, since the cover is a little more delicate. And I have another design that has flowers on it that match my Moroccan party set. This is the one that matches the Michelin style set, party set. And again, I lined up the opposite ends with perforations that are on the paper. And let that dry for a second, and we're going to do the same thing. I'm going to add glue to each of these tabs. That's why I like this small glue bottle, small dispenser. It's easier to handle. And we'll put the cover on, just like so. Make sure it completely covers the whole lid. And wait for a little bit for it to dry. Okay, now that it's adhering, we'll turn it around and tap all our little tabs, make sure they're attached. And now all we need to do is stick this other end onto the inside. All you have to do is just add glue all over pretty generously, and just make sure that your slits line up with the one on the inside. And they line up perfectly right there. And I press, rub it all around, and there you have it. That's the finished cover. Now that we finished the cover, all we need to do is thread it through the top, just like so, and slide it over the box, which is a nice snug little fit. Pull the ribbon, and you're done. And here's a variation. I have a little graduation hat. It's the same concept, except instead of adding a circle at the top of your box, you're adding a square. But it's basically the same idea. And that's the project. I hope you like it. Thanks for watching.